Las Vegas, Nevada, and the surrounding counties. Let's make it official and give a big warm welcome to Mr. Jensen, Ackles, and Jared Padalecki. Give them hell, boys.
Yeah.
Hi. Who put my chair backwards?
Listen, I had to make room. Sometimes I don't know where these things are gonna fly.
Jeez. All right, I'll scooch over. Y'all want to see something funny? I've showed it to a few friends. I don't know if it's funny, but it's.
We'll be the judge of that.
Yeah. Okay. Laugh, yell, cry, scream. It occurred to me before I jump. So I don't have an ACL on my left leg right now. So watch.
Oh!
That's hilarious.
Anyways, love y'all. I'll jump for you.
You know what the...
Where's the joke?
The joke is that his brother is an orthopedic surgeon.
Not fun.
Get that fixed, man.
I'm in season. I can't fix it right
You're
now.
You're in season? He is.
That deserved a rim shot.
No, you might want to get that looked at.
It's been looked at.
That's not normal.
It's not.
Your knee is not supposed to bend inward.
It's a fun park trick. It's not
yeah,
fun.
Until it gets stuck like that.
It's not fun. I lift it, put it back. Sometimes. Anyways, hi guys, girls.
Happy New Year, everybody, for those who we haven't seen yet today.
It's January.
Listen, it's January.
How long until you
stop saying Happy New Year?
We're going to ask some questions, but we have...
Well, let's answer that question first.
There are more of them, they're more smartly. Smarter.
Stop trying.
When is it too late to... Say Happy New Year.
February 1st.
February.
Okay.
Can we all agree on that?
Yeah.
Okay, can you also agree that your Christmas lights for ambient lighting can stay up later than that?
Yeah.
For ambient lighting?
It gets dark half of the day, dude.
Clear.
They're white. What's a clear light? Is it a clear light or?
What's clear mean?
You've been to my house.
You know what kind of light.
Listen, it's the whole how long can you leave your Christmas lights up? I'm gonna say.
All year. Stand up. Who said all year? Thank you.
Listen, you can leave them up all year, but turn that shit off a week after New Year's. All right? I don't want to see it.
But you still want to say Happy
New
Year?
You know why? Because it doesn't make them special when you get to turn them on.
That's right, yeah.
If you got them up all year, if you got them on all year, it's not special.
They're not on during the day.
You stop talking to me.
Fair enough. All right, so some disagreements. One young person who is very correct. Lights.
Okay, since we're on the topic, when do you turn them on?
When the sun goes down.
The weekend after Thanksgiving.
Yes.
No.
What?
Yes.
Halloween? Surrounded by a bunch of communists.
I read a meme, and it was like, it's just words, and it said something like, oh my god, I cannot believe my...
Isn't that what a meme is?
Well, they give me pictures too.
It's right? Pictures with words on them.
No, there's no picture, just words.
It's just words.
Yeah.
That's awesome. That's not a meme.
It's a poem.
That's just text.
It said something like, it's only October.
We're really gonna figure it all out today, guys. It's all getting figured out up here.
That's right.
It said,
I hope you're taking notes.
It's only October 10th, and my dumb neighbor already put up Halloween decorations. Yeah. It's totally distracting from my Christmas lights. And I was like, yep, same.
Buddy.
Same. Hashtag. Anyways, sorry. Now that we've solved that and all the problems.
I don't think we did. But moving on.
I think we got it.
Agree to disagree.
Let's go ahead.
Is your Christmas tree still up?
We were in Australia for Christmas.
They never put one up.
We had Christmas sand. We had a kangaroo bone.
So we went away for the holidays. We were gone for Christmas all through New Year's, but Daniil had put up our tree at home, right after Thanksgiving. I was filming in Albuquerque, so she went ahead and put it up. The day we got back, which I think was January 3rd, on the 4th, I had to pack that entire tree up. I had to put, because we've got one of those like new trees that can the lights, it puts on a light show for you. Yeah, have you seen these things?
Yes.
The tree puts on a light show?
Oh my gosh, it's amazing.
Does it dance?
Yes, it does. And it makes an amazing beef stroganoff, too. I had to get that sucker.
Heart?
I had to get that sucker down immediately. It's like I'm failing right now.
What's your favorite stroganoff? Come on, guys. We're solving the problems of the world right now.
We're not gonna solve that problem.
But he is handsome. On that note, hi, how are you?
Hi. My name's Shauna. It's nice to meet you both.
Nice to meet you both.
My question is for both of you. I was just wondering, you guys do a lot of stunts and you're doing different projects right now. I was wondering if you ever get nervous, whether it's a scene you're going to shoot or an audition you're going to, how you overcome your fears and go and do that.
Of the stunt or the scene in general?
Whatever it may be that you're scared of in the moment.
Are there bears involved?
Possibly, yes.
Not doing that scene.
Dude, did you see that video of the bear walking down the highway?
I don't want to see it.
And there was a construction cone that had been tipped over, and the bear literally rights it and then keeps walking. Not kidding. Did you guys see that?
Yes.
Yes. Literally just cruising down the highway, and it just goes.
Okay.
What?
I've been saying that for years. They're alien beings to kill us all.
No.
And correct traffic violations.
I didn't track that bear down and I gave him a key to your house, so.
Guess I'm not going home. Hey, Jen. So Jensen did something.
How do you overcome
fear during scenes? I don't, so.
I'd say I'm less fearful of stunt scenes than I am of emotional scenes.
Stunts,
that's fun. That's, just get to throw yourself against a wall or dive over a table or get into a fake fight.
Yeah, and as far as stunts go, at least on Supernatural and on Walker, in my experience, by the time I do a stunt on Walker, it's been done 10, 15, 20 times by my stunt man and our stunt coordinator, Chad Bashnell. So I feel like you feel safe and secure. Something could go wrong no matter what. In my experience, I've been more physically injured during a scene that didn't require a stunt double than on the scenes that were like, okay, here's where you jump through a window in this cathedral and you fall two floors, which we did in season 4 of us.
Didn't get hurt at all.
Didn't.
Although you asked him to get into the back seat of a car, and he rips the scalp off.
Yeah. Have y'all heard that story?
No.
Okay. Oh yeah, this is a good story.
It was first episode of season 3.
Yeah.
When Bobby drives his car,
the Chevelle,
like into the scene.
In the restaurant or something?
Yeah, and then we jump in the car and peel
out. So Bobby's Chevelle, it was supposed to look like an old beater, so it was a two-door, like 67 Chevelle. No weather stripping on the windows, it's all rusted out. And so Kim Manners is directing. It was like the first one about the Four Horsemen or something, whatever. Seven Deadly Sins, I think it might have been called. Something about, I think it was season 3, episode 1. And so we're shooting the sequence, and I'm not a short person, and Bobby and Dean get in the front seat, and so I have to hop into the back seat. It's not really,
it's not a minivan.
There's no delicate way
no sliding door
for me to like crawl into, it's not gonna look very graceful. And so I have to like open the door, get the little latch on this vintage car to put the seat forward and kind of crawl in. And Manners is yelling from the village where he's watching playback. He's like, "Hurry up, you're running from a demon." I'm like, "Kim, I'm not 5'2", dude. Like, it takes me a while to make myself fit into this seat." He's like, "Well, we're only a 42 minute show." Because I was on shows for 42 minutes with 18 minutes of commercials. And so I was like, all right, I got it. And so we, did take two, and did take three, and did take four. And I'm just basically launching myself in the car. I'm banging into everything. And then after probably five or six more takes, our key hair worker.
Well, no, it was like after the third take or something.
Jeannie Chow
comes up and starts like fixing his hair.
My hair, yeah.
And she like
she looks
pulls
at me
a clump of hair out and goes.
She's like.
And like doesn't say anything, just like, "Oh my gosh, he's losing his hair." She was like, "Okay," started thinking about like, "We're gonna have to get him on Rogaine, we're gonna have to start." Like starts like formulating a plan, and then comes back the next take and takes off now not just hair, but there's like now skin attached and like blood.
Scalp.
And she's like, "What is?" And finally she like looks at your hair, and you were scalping yourself off the top of the car every time you got in.
Yeah, the window didn't have weather stripping, so it was just exposed metal. I had to get a tetanus shot. So I'm just trying to launch in, I'm banging everything, so I'm like, whatever. But the metal was pulling. I hit my head on a lot of stuff. Y'all can't tell. So I had scalped myself, literally. Like I had taken off. Funny enough, years later, when I had the Crossroads Demon thing, so Jeannie had given it to Robin, our on-set props, and Robin had like put it in the safe, like
the hair
with the scalp, and I used it as my Crossroads Demon summoning thing. Yeah. So,
listen, we're serious about our summoning skills, okay?
Yeah. So, but again, no stuntman required. I was getting into a vehicle, and I lost my scalp.
I don't think we've answered your question at all. The question was, how do you overcome your fear?
Buy more scalp.
Yeah. That's a really good question. I think it depends on the situation and, just kind of what fear we're feeling. I know he and I are similar in the fact that when we're doing a scene, to some degree, there's just kind of this focusing on what we're doing that's right in front of us, and it's almost like everything else blurs away. And in that 2 to 3 minutes that we're doing a scene, nothing else is being thought of other than playing that character in that moment with whoever else is in that scene. And it's just, it's an interesting feeling because when they yell cut, the real world floods back into your mind. You're like, oh, okay, so it's almost this weird like checking out of the real world for a couple of minutes and then checking back in.
Yeah, 100%. And for me, thinking about it, say season one of Supernatural or two and three and four progressively, I progressively got less and less fearful. The fear is still there, but it's almost like you do something. I remember season one being really nervous about emotional scenes, about some stunt scenes, about some exposition scenes, and then you do it, and then the next day you wake up and just keep on carrying on, and you're like, oh, that wasn't the end of the world. Like, it's okay to rip off the Band-Aid because the sun will still rise, ideally, and it has still since 2005. And so I think there was a kind of a life lesson for Jared and possibly for Ackles also, where it's like, hey, just do it, just do your best. Like all you can do is your best. And so I think I've kind of gradually accepted that, and that's helped.
What's that like, there's a saying or something, like do something every day that scares you, or something like that, right? And I think the lesson in that is that the more you do something, the more you push yourself, and the more you do stuff that does give you pause, the better at it you're gonna be. And so I think that if there is something that scares you, or if there is something that that you're hesitant on trying, or if it's a scene or something, or if it's, you know, if it's talking to somebody, whatever it might be, the more you can do that, the easier it's going to be. So it got really easy for us after 15 years. Yeah.
Thank you so much for your question.
Thanks.
There's a fan right here.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
I got it.
It's not even on.
It's on.
Is it on?
Yeah.
Where's my fan? Wasn't a joke.
It was funny though.
Not really.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. My name's Shannon, and I went to Vancouver Con to see you guys, and I'm glad you're here this time, Jared. I was just wondering.
Thank you, Shannon.
I was wondering, when you guys go back to Vancouver, is there somewhere you always try and eat, or somewhere you always try and go back to?
Yeah, Gotham, Chipino's. Those two for sure. Where else would you go?
I mean, at this point, yeah, there's certainly favorite restaurants that we had over the years. Gotham's a steakhouse. Chipino's is a Mediterranean seafood place. There's really good sushi in Vancouver. At this point now, like when we go back to Vancouver, we want to go see people that we miss. I'd rather go and sit at a dining table and one of our crew members' houses then sit at a restaurant. So, yeah. Thank you, Shannon.
Hi, my name's Lynn. I was born and raised here in Vegas. I know there's a few of us here.
More than a few.
Yeah. So my question is for your characters on Supernatural. If Sam and Dean kept a journal the way that John did, what would be their top hits as far as drawing and what they would put into it about the monsters and the hunts?
Good question. Can I clarify what top hits means? I think it's probably a phrase.
Like, what would be...
I bet in Sam's journal, Ruby would probably be dog-eared. You know what I'm saying? I think.
Don't fall for the first one. Wait for the second one to come along.
Asterisk.
I'm gonna say Wendigo would be up there on how to handle that. I would say the top hit. This will be a number one, numero uno, would be Yellow-Eyed Demon.
See, I didn't start my journal until after we killed Azazel, so I think I'm still Ruby, Lucifer. maybe Gadriel Ezekiel. Solus Sam. That would be my journal? Okay.
Be in Dean's. obviously vampires,
Chuck.
Ghouls, gens.
Gens. Yeah. I think Chuck.
Leviathans.
Yeah. Fairies. Angels.
Fairies. It'd just be one page with three words. Fight the fairies. That's it. That's all you need. And then maybe in very small letters at the very bottom of the page, it just says microwave.
Or maybe it's in micro writing and it just says wave. It's worth a shot. Yeah, maybe a little bit about us.
Who would be your top hit?
I would say...
What did you enjoy us fighting the most?
I would say how to deal with Crowley, just on a personal basis.
The problem is, if you write about Crowley in your journal, you have to read about Crowley in the future. So I would keep him.
No, you wouldn't, because Crowley would do it for you.
That's a good point.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you, Lynn.
Hey there.
Hi guys, my name's Heather. Thanks for being here, love you both. My question is for Jensen. I'm just wondering your insights into Demon Dean's indifference toward Baby.
I think it was Demon Dean's indifference towards just about anything. That's what kind of made him a demon, was that he did not care about humans or anything in the human world, except maybe karaoke. Yeah. Sweet, sweet pipes on that guy.
Like I said,
vocal cords. I think it was more just a general indifference towards anything. Probably explained it. Although, that's a hard one to be indifferent about, even if you are a demon. How dare he? And I will say this, that must have been really painful for Dean to watch this, you know, demon take his vessel and then not care about the car. Yeah, that was tough. It was tough on Dean. It was tough on me. It was hard to play. It's hard to play. Thank you.
Thank you. Hi.
Hi, I'm Lisa from Georgia, and last year I had a milestone birthday but couldn't celebrate because I broke my back. And so I was trying to do this year as a redo year. Any suggestions?
Don't break your back again. It's probably a reasonable way to start. I thought that was funny.
I thought for sure you were going to be like, well, we're glad you're back. That was the obvious one. Just kind of left that one hanging there.
I thought the non-obvious was funnier.
Well, let me ask you this. What were some of the things you were looking forward to doing that year that you did not get to do?
Not backward.
I missed 5 conventions, 4 trips, 9 concerts, and I wasn't able to drive for 7 months.
Oh, wow. It sounds to me like you need to get in a car, you need to drive...
For 7 months.
You need to drive for 7 months and hit all the different cities where the bands that you like are playing, go to those concerts, come see us a few times, because we've got a few more of these shows this year, and then boom, there's your checklist.
Happy birthday, happy late birthday. Glad you're back. It's cool. Don't worry about it, guys.
They're not worried about it. Hi.
Hi, my name's Danny. This is my first convention, and I'm so excited to be here, so thank you so much for being here. My question to you both is, what is the worst thing you think Sam and Dean ever did, and why was it leaving Adam in the cage?
I will offer this as not a rebuttal, but something to consider. We never really had Adam. You know? I think if Adam was Adam, not a ghoul, we would have done our damnedest. But I think Sam and Dean kind of had to go into hunter mode and go like, oh, and I think that's kind of what the magic of it was, because I love the question. I think it's legit, because if Sam and Dean did have that, and I think Jared and Jensen and probably all y'all wanted some win like that for the Winchester brothers. But it, like many things in their lives, came with a big old asterisk of bad news. And so that was kind of, you know, Supernatural, that, as y'all all know, was kind of tragic. It was comedic at times, but just nothing ever really went just right for the boys. And we had a few episodes, obviously, you know, like we had our Christmas episode, we were able to give gifts to each other. We had our times where we got to do laundry in the middle of his bunker, and we got to kind of have a birthday party, but everything kind of had, I think Dean said in a few episodes, I'm just waiting for the other shoe to drop. So I think the boys were used to the other shoe dropping, and when it dropped, it broke my heart. I'm sure it broke his, obviously broke yours, I think a lot of ours. So I I think Du Bois did the right thing with Adam, as horrible as that sounds. But I don't think Sam needed to spend so much time with Amelia. Yeah. I didn't write it. She's awesome. She's lovely, but I think he would have went after his brother a little bit earlier.
The worst thing Dean did was probably not dodge a little stick of rebar.
Too soon.
I mean, just a little pen.
Yeah.
That's all I needed. Just a little pen. Six more seasons.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Hi there.
Hi. Jensen, I have to tell you, my husband loved you as Soldier Boy. He quotes me constantly.
He quotes me constantly?
Constantly, yes.
Gotta watch out for that. That's some of those quotes can get you in trouble.
So my question is, if you had the opportunity to be cast as a villain or a superhero, what would you choose or what would you like to be?
I mean, I think I got to do it. Both. I was a superhero and kind of a villain. Kind of. And I say kind of because you know why? He didn't think he was bad.
Yeah. That doesn't matter. Neither did Hitler.
He was the hero of his own story. That's true. I mean, are you talking about a certain verse, like a certain universe, like Marvel? DC.
If you had the opportunity to do something else, in addition to Soldier Boy, what would you want?
I'd have to say, and even though I do get to voice it, I would be Batman. And to be a villain, I mean, I don't think I'd ever want this job, but I could certainly, I mean, it would be my favorite one. It would be the the opposite of Batman, the Joker. But no, thank you. That's I don't want to go down that road. Yeah. What about you?
Me? I'm not super interested in exploring the superhero kind of journey and tropes and archetypes. I would love to play a villain. I think maybe like Elon Musk. Come on! That was the most milquetoast rim shot of all time.
You really limped in with that one.
I like the psychological mind games. So something in that arena. I honestly don't have a specific villain picked out.
He'd want to shave his head and play Lex Luthor.
I could never follow in Rosie's footsteps. He's too badass. But thank you so much for your question.
Hello, I'm Amy from Illinois, and this is my 15th year of cons. I just wanted to ask, I know Jensen, you have some things in the pipeline, but do both of you have new works in the pipeline?
I don't. If y'all chat with Kat, Walker Independence finished season one, so woo! Yeah. And that still has a few episodes to air. We're still shooting Walker season 3. Go back this week, I'm gonna have to see Spate again in my hometown.
would you quit bringing him to Austin?
I know.
He just won't stop calling and going, hey man, let's go out to your brewery so I can get some free beer.
He sends, as you well know, he sends so many emails, hey, when am I directing? Hey, when am I directing? Hey, when am I directing? Hey, when am I directing?
That's true, he's incessant.
Yeah, it's just easier to just go like, all right, give him an episode. Okay. So I just have Walker still going. Hoping to see you guys a lot this year. And we'll see what happens with Walker and Wendy when we see what happens with Walker and Wendy. You know, so I don't have anything else.
Did you say Wendy?
Walker in minutes. Wendy. What do you call it, Wendy?
Oh. I thought you were doing something with, like, the...
Farting.
No, with Wendy's.
Yes. I'm doing the new Wendy's campaign. For the Frosties.
Cool.
Not even cool. Cold.
That was good.
It hurts.
Here, put the thumb on the roof of your mouth.
Oh, what?
Y'all know that trick? If you get brain freeze. You don't know the trick? If you get brain freeze. Your thumb to the roof of your mouth.
Oh no, I just deal with it like a normal person.
Okay, fair enough. You should throw. that's me.
I've got a few things coming this year. I've got a pretty busy first few months of the year. On multiple projects, and then I just signed a deal that I don't think I can talk about just yet, but it'll probably be press released soon, so you'll see what that is, and then that's leading to some stuff in development. So yeah,
thank you. Hi.
Hi, Jensen and Jared. My name is Erica, and my question is about the mystery spot, which I know goes back. I'm doing a rewatch. If the roles were reversed and Dean had to watch Sam die, how long would it take Dean to figure it out, and what would Gabriel have been trying to teach Dean?
It would have taken Dean much longer to figure it out, because I don't know if you've seen that movie, Groundhog Day.
Yeah.
But Bill Murray's character starts to enjoy himself, knowing that he has no consequences of tomorrow. Dean would immediately go down that road, and that could last for some time, before he decides that he's bored with that and should probably fix the situation he's in. So, I think he would be around a while.
We'd still be filming Supernatural.
We'd still, yeah.
I'd just be dying every episode.
Oh my God, your brother just died. Oh yeah, that happens. Well, what are you up to later? I know. And the lesson that be trying to teach Dean, I don't know that there wouldn't necessarily need to be one. Get your head out of your ass. Could be that. Don't eat tacos. You would eat the tacos. Yeah, but maybe that's it. Be like, hey, listen, your brother died because he ate tacos.
If you come back to life.
Careful what you eat. Stick to Wendy's.
And then it's a picture, it's a commercial with me.
And yeah, with your thumb on the roof of your mouth.
Saying, try the new Wendy's Frosty. It's not just cool, it's cold.
And that, my friends, is how advertising is done. We are here to announce our new advertising agency, J&J Ads.
Thank you, Erica.
Thank you.
Hi. Hey there.
Hi. It's my first convention, and it's been so awesome to meet so many cool people, so I want to start off with that. Thank
Welcome.
You all for being so kind and welcoming.
Amazing.
Welcome to you.
And I have a question for Jensen, but the prelude to my question is, Chelsea Caponier, will you marry me?
What? Get over here.
I feel like that's a bigger question. Chelsea?
Is that a real question?
Is it a Chelsea?
Get over here. Chelsea, get over here. Where are you, Chelsea?
Where's Chelsea?
Hey, brother. Come here.
She's in the bathroom.
Chelsea, get up here. Here.
Don't fall.
But it's happening for you.
question for you.
Chelsea. I did tell her, because I didn't know I'd get my question, my name pulled for a question, but maybe an angel or maybe even God had a hand in it. Or maybe, hopefully not, Lucifer. Chelsea Campanier, will you marry me?
Yes.
And Jensen Ackles, will you sing at our wedding?
What do you sing? It's happy birthday. No, that's not. That's
how about Tennessee whiskey?
Tennessee. Listen, if I have an opportunity to sing at your wedding, I'm gonna have
October
to take
you up 7th. On
that. October. You already have a date? Have a wedding.
How was I gonna ask you?
What? She's like, I love the fall. We've talked about the date for years. I just didn't think you'd take me up on it. Listen, you let me know, and if I can be there, I'd love to sing for you. You're gonna want to walk her down those stairs and make sure she doesn't fall. She's a little shaky. Well, hey, let's give it up for these two lovebirds. Congratulations. Well, that's a first. Just a day of firsts.
Anyways, what's your question for me? Congratulations, guys.
Wow.
All right, very cool.
Okay.
All right, going over here, beat
and,
that.
And I gotta say, the hat game, guys, is on point.
Yeah.
Haberdashery was dashing.
Stop it.
Come on!
Listen, man, you've already got a couple. Just take the wins.
That's fair.
All right?
Good point. It's a new year.
Okay, that's a really hard question to follow. I first want to thank you, Jared, for giving me one of the most memorable experiences as a mom that I've ever had. My twins had their photo op with you today, and the way that you fixed their hair for them prior to just will be in my heart forever. So thank you for that.
My honor. Thank you.
And then this question, I think you might have some funny response for this, but I'm a middle school teacher, and everybody who knows middle schoolers are a lot of fun. I'm kind of curious what kind of middle school boys you were, and if you have any advice for my middle schoolers. They were pretty impressed I was going to meet you, so.
Wow. Yeah. Do you have access to a nanny of some sort, or someone else who can raise the kids for those years? Just kidding. I think I was actually a decent middle school kid.
I was not.
Tell me more.
Avoid having your parents called in the middle of the night by the police department two counties over.
Oh. Middle school?
That was a long ride home. But you know, with today's technology, I could sneak out and be gone forever.
Don't tell her that.
But now most middle schoolers have phones or, you know, Apple watches or tracking devices like mine will. And you can't get away with the kind of stuff that I would get away with back in the day. So I would say, don't do that. But you're still young enough to where it can be fun.
Are your middle schoolers here right now?
Oh, no, I'm a middle school teacher.
She's a teacher.
Oh,
My children are older, but I teach middle school.
She's talking about for her class.
You know what? I have a serious answer. I've very proudly been in therapy for the last 8 years, give or take. And when Jen and I started dating, she had already done therapy and found it beneficial. And we also have our kids seeing a therapist. Just like kind of tell him something they wouldn't tell us. But one time we were talking with our kids therapist, and he said there's a really interesting way to pose a question to a child. And you know, at the time our kids were like 4, 8, and 9 or whatever they were. But he said if you need to ask them something serious, it's often wise to lead like this? You say, what's your name again?
My name is Brenda.
Brenda. So if I was asking you, if you were my middle school student, I would say, Brenda, I'm going to ask you a few questions. And just so you know, some of these questions I already know the answer to. Did you paint bad words on the wall or whatever? And you might, because sometimes you have to ask a kid and they just need to admit it. But their instinct, because they're defensive, is like, no, no. And you're like, okay, I'm going to ask you some questions and I may already know the answer to some of these. So I need you to be honest with me. And just have, because it's really tough. I'm going through that with my kids right now where they instinctually just want to go like, no. And I'll be like, hey, did you leave your laundry on the floor? No. Like, you're not in trouble, dude. I just needed to know if it's dirty or clean, you know? So it's just, like, I guess people go through phases. But that's something, and it's worked for us. And you're not lying, because a lot of times you know the answer. But that helped me on a serious note.
I'm going to use that. I would say this to middle schoolers and also high schoolers, and that is, you only get one go around with that experience. Try to get as much out of it as you possibly can. One of the reasons that I'm up here on this stage today is because I had somebody important in my high school life that said, hey, you should go try out for that that spring play, that spring. And I was like, I can't, I've got baseball. Yeah, but you've been playing baseball for the last several years.
And you suck.
You should go try as much as you possibly can, because you never know what doors might open. So I would encourage middle school students, high school students, to try to expand as much of their experience within that space as they possibly can. Take a photography class, take shop class, you know, join a team, try to play an instrument, learn a different language. You know, who knows? Who knows where that might lead? Don't just try to pick a lane when you're in seventh grade and stick to it for the next 6 years or whatever it is. Try to really get as much of what that experience, what that portion of your life can offer, because it's a lot.
Thank you and good luck.
Hi. My name's Sharon.
Hi, Sharon.
I'm just shaking. I'm sorry.
You're awesome. Don't worry about it.
Hi. First thing, I'm a zookeeper, so if you live in the United States, most of the bears are black bears, and they're more afraid of you than you are of them.
Sharon, it sounds to me like you're full of shit.
My question is...
No, I'm sorry.
This is my fourth time watching the Supernatural series.
Wow.
But I've never watched the last episode, and I was wondering, because the second to the last makes kind of the perfect ending.
Yep.
So I was wondering if you guys think I should watch it or not.
Yes.
If you should watch the finale, yeah. The final episode?
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah, why not? You've come this far. Go ahead and tie it up with a bow.
Put it this way, it's better than bugs.
Anything.
No, it's sorry, I didn't mean to scare you away. God, I yell at her and I said the S word.
Yeah,
no,
what's wrong with you?
I think...
it's just bears.
If you, how about this? If you get through... how far are you in your fourth watch through? Yeah, you know what? I do think it's worth it. It's tough to watch. Difficult.
Yeah, but here's the thing. We watch these shows and we follow these characters and we follow these storylines because they draw emotion out of us. And it's an escape from our life, and we get to go on this journey with these two brothers, and we get to experience what that story and what that journey is through these guys. So I think by not watching the final episode, I think you're robbing yourself of the emotional journey that we got to go through.
And also, if I may add to that, amen to that, but remember when you watch it, that it's the final episode of Supernatural, but it doesn't necessarily mean that it's the last episode of Supernatural. Thank you. And keep keeping those zoos.
What does that even mean?
Keep keeping?
No, I get it, but I just, like, stop. Thank you.
I was going to say, hey, when you're at the zoo, zoom with me, because it kind of is a play on zoo and zoom. But I thought keep keeping was quicker. A little, you know, brevity is the soul of wit. Okay. Hi there, how are you?
Hi, my name is Susan, and I'm from Phoenix. Good to see you guys. It's a little cold in here, and I was going to wear my camouflage jacket, but I couldn't see myself in it.
Yeah, that was well deserved.
So that was mostly for you, Jared, because I do have a Jensen question.
I love it.
I've got
it's great. It's great.
There you go.
I'll take that.
Jensen.
I win.
It was wonderful to see you perform Radio Company in Nashville. You did such a wonderful job. Thank you very much for doing that. But you left us hanging. When is the third album coming out?
As soon as it's finished. It is currently being mastered. So it is in the mastering process right now. So hopefully by the end of this month, if not February, I would assume.
Thank you.
Thank you. And thank you for understanding how to deliver a punchline.
Yeah. What?
What? No, no, just keep on keeping on, Zookeeper.
Hi, my name is Caitlin, and first off I wanted to say, Jensen, family business is beautiful. My husband took us on a family trip a few months ago, and we got to go, and it was such a gorgeous brewery, and your beer is delicious.
Was it a family trip or a business trip?
It was a family trip.
And I heard it too, I could hear him thinking about it behind me. It's like an old rusty cog of wheels behind me, just... Oh, this one sounds terrible. Let's say it. Such an idiot. You'll have to excuse my friend. Well, thank you. That's awfully nice of you. Yes, I'm quite fond of that place as well.
And my question was, over the seasons of Supernatural, you guys had such amazing, iconic guest stars, and I was just wondering if you could have had anyone on the show, who would it have been, and what or who would they have played?
That wasn't on the show?
Yes.
Oh.
God, I mean, the list is long. Great question. I mean, fresh to mind, and these conversations were had, Tom and Rosie. Yeah. Trap anyways. We tried to get Amel on the show.
Yeah.
We tried to be on a different show where we come into a town and kill two vampire brothers.
That would have been a fun crossover.
It would have been fun. And they're both friends, legitimately. So I think I was here with them once, like I came to
VD
convention.
Yeah, we're much
and
more.
And a Vampire Diaries convention.
Just the thought of a venereal disease convention.
I didn't know. Want to spill it out?
I apologize for him.
They know. They know. Right.
They're apologizing to me. They're like, hey, don't sorry us. You don't want us to sit next to him.
I would love for Milo to come on the show.
Yeah, I was gonna say we're much more likely to pick friends of ours than like, oh, we'd love for Brad Pitt to come on or have, you know, George Clooney come, like, We would much rather have friends and people that we have good relationships with and know are you know, super talented come on and because it's fun. What we get to do is a lot of fun when you have people that have fun with you. And that's really, I think, what it's a large reason why a lot of these faces that you're seeing on Walker and a lot of the faces that you're seeing on, you know, Winchester's or even up on this stage are familiar faces. It's because we want to continue working with the people that we like. We want to continue playing with people that enjoy playing.
Thank you so much.
I think he's lost his keys. And you know what?
It's the last question.
It's the last question. There's no more questions.
It's the very last question.
You know what it is?
It's the last question.
He just said, it's the last question.
This is it.
I'm gonna let you know real quick. Okay, hey, Robbie.
It's the last question.
Is somebody out there willing to turn this on real fast?
Hi.
This is.
How are you?
What is this? Were you trying to? I think you were.
Just call a phone.
I think she's gonna video. Right? Do you want this on camera? Sure.
She said sure. Was that your question? Oh, you're just typing out notes to yourself.
Oh, never mind.
You got it. You got your question. Because you know what this is, right?
Hey guys.
This is.
Supernatural family, welcome Tracy from Massachusetts, also part of the Supernatural family. Tracy, say hi to your fam. Brothers and sisters from another mother and Blister.
This is my first convention.
Oh, welcome.
Thank you. So let me see if I can get my question. My son is autistic. And he's pretty much like Rain Man, and everything is like repetitive with him. And one of the things is like the songs that he listens to in the car, they're like the same songs over and over and over again. So can you think of a song that you've heard so many times that you're just sick of listening?
Let me ask you. What's the first song that comes to your mind that your son makes you listen to over and over and over again?
Katy Perry's Firework.
Firework. I went through a firework phase.
Yeah.
I did.
Yeah.
I had to listen to that crap every day I got the kids to school, and yep, it was awful. It was a dark time in my life.
I'm trying to think of some of the songs that get into my head that my kids sing or someone sings, and I can't get out of my head. What'd you say? That was, what was it? Your simulation, you're reading my mind. So thank goodness it kind of went away in general, but did you ever go through a Baby Shark phase?
My son's 21. No, I didn't go through Baby Shark.
No, Baby Shark, that's good.
That was a difficult
he's
one.
He's autistic, he still watches the Teletubbies, so he's autistic.
Great.
I mean, I still watch the Teletubbies. Yeah.
He's like 83.
It's totally acceptable.
It's a good show.
It is really good show. Yes, no.
Dude, last season?
I mean, amazing.
Boom.
Yeah, the arc on that?
Ridiculous.
It's insane. Yeah.
As far as radio songs, I think a lot of the songs on the radio right now I don't love listening to on a regular basis, but I don't listen to the radio a lot, unfortunately, but all the theme songs from different movies and kids' movies and stuff. Yeah, you hear me. Yeah, you agree.
Man.
Let It Go.
Oh, I listen to Let It Go.
I like Let It Go.
A million times.
Go.
No, my daughter, my oldest, she's, what's that? It's a Shawn Mendes song that I have to listen to.
Shawn Mendes was created in a lab for every little girl to have a crush on.
And grown man.
He's super cute. Super cute. Yeah.
That last season was oof.
I mean, by the way, the finale? Fireworks.
No. Say nothing.
I had no idea.
No, say nothing.
Yeah, that's good luck with that. and we're gonna continue to weather those storms in the car when listening to songs that we don't like incessantly, or even bands that we don't like. Maroon 5. That's,
that season was.
It eats away at your soul.
The
a
last
bit.
Season?
I mean, dude.
The last season of Teletubbies.
Maroon 6? I get why you don't like Maroon 5, but Maroon 6 was solid.
I never saw that coming.
Whole season.
Thank you.
Is it this? You could have said it.
That's the last question, guys.
That was it.
That was the last question. That was the last question.
All right, yeah.
That was the very, very last question. There are no more questions. Six and you're like off mic. I was gonna say it.
I was like, no, Norton doesn't think it's funny. His face is like, Maroon 6.
I sound that's, like Jensen.
That's uncanny. Okay, we have a special little thing that we need to point out and draw some attention to. Spade's gonna help us with that. Richard. You got something back there?
It happens to be the birthday of our very own Mr. Billy Moran!
Hey! Oh, it's the same cake we had yesterday.
We're using the same cakes yesterday.
Yep.
It's, because times are tight.
It's a birthday weekend.
Hey, Keegan wasn't free. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm saying.
Keegan ate into our cake budget.
Same candles. The candles are about to go out, so we better.
So let's sing to Mr. Billy Moran. Happy birthday. Here we go. Right, take it.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Billy. Happy birthday to you.
Hey, Billy Moran, ladies and
gentlemen. I gotta say, I gotta say, watching you, one of my favorite things is when people start happy birthday, and you know damn well what I'm gonna say.
You're like, start too high.
Yeah, start
too high.
And you started too high, and you brought it down. You gotta tell the Brad Kreiser version of this, because Brad famously, you know.
Famously starts so high. He got nowhere to go. He starts at the ceiling. Happy birthday! No, you're hooped.
And the funny thing is, it comes out of a man. Everybody, it's Billy Moran's birthday. I want us to gather around and do a happy birthday for the man on the guitar. Happy birthday!
Also,
dogs are barking across the street.
Glass is breaking.
Well done.
Glass is shattering.
Richard, you were like, take it away, Robbie. And I was like, oh shit, so happy birthday to you. He took his arm to put my. Because I'm the only one on mic. Just.
Happy birthday.
It's been an amazing birthday weekend for Mr. Billy Moran, who, by the way, is maybe the most talented man on the circuit with us, truly. Billy Moran, great man, great guitar player. And Vegas has been a great weekend. Let's give it up for Mr. Jensen Ackles and Jared Padalecki.